Welcome to the Kenai River in southwest Alaska. Known for its rugged beauty, fly fishermen from around the world travel to this glacially fed river to fish for rainbow trout. And not just any rainbow trout, but big rainbow trout in some of the most rich and pristine waters in North America. Fishing seems easy here at times. Moments from the launch, we hooked into our first fish. It was a big, beautiful dolly varden with brilliant pink spots and a striking white skirt along its fins. But it does take a unique skill set to fish for Kenai rainbows. Patience and concentration, balance and reflexes, and well, the rest is self-explanatory.
Oh, he got beautiful.
Yeah, look at that. That's a nice fish.
He hit one and then it broke off and he hit that one right afterwards. Watch it.
These would be the first of many fish we would catch on the Kenai River, with most of these rainbows averaging 18 to 22 inches. These fall rainbows were gorging themselves for a long winter and readily took a variety of beads and flesh flies. This nice rainbow took a small peach and white marble bead pattern. True to our conservation ethic, we all took great care in handling and releasing all the trout that we caught. Of course, trout fishing isn't just for the guys, and very often the ladies outfish the men. Even a small dolly varden can present a great thrill for the newly baptized fly fisher. Nevertheless, it's the big rainbows that bring people to the Kenai.
If everybody kept the fish, there wouldn't be any fish left.
Well, he just keeps taking more line out, doesn't he?
If you're lucky, you'll get to catch one of those lifetime fish.
It's a big one.
Nice. Wow, that's a huge one, honey. Beautiful. Well, you're in the shade a little bit, so I'm trying to see if you can see his colors a little bit. Yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah. Do you want the photo?
Oh, yeah.
That's a beauty. Let him go. Come on, buddy. Wow, that's a big fish. Look at that.
Fucking salmon. Look at that. Thank you.
multiple hookups aren't uncommon. Doubles, triples, and even quadruples can result in the elegant dance known only as the Kenai Rainbow Waltz. The Kenai Rainbow Waltz can be a complicated series of steps, going underneath raised bent rods, shuffling through the swift current, stumbling over rocks, all culminating in an occasional curtsy with a rainbow trout. When it gets to be late afternoon and it's time to go back to the camp, the best fish to end the day on is, of course, the biggest fish.
Will I get soaked unless you want to?
It's important to note the reason why the Kenai River rainbows get so large. It is because of the prolific salmon runs that return to the Kenai every year. As huge numbers of king, sockeye, and silver salmon lay their eggs and die, they complete the cycle of life critical to the ecosystem's health, and also to those rainbow trout that live in that ecosystem. The salmon life cycle is not only important to the rainbows of the Kenai, but it is also a critical food source to other animals that live around the river, including bears, eagles, foxes, and even moose, as the salmon carry nutrients that nourish the plants along the water's edge that the moose depends on. Of course, the best way to end the day is relaxing with friends back at the cabin, sharing the stories of the day, the fish caught and the fish lost, probably sprinkled with a few lies intermixed. I know we left with many good memories of some great fishing on the Kenai River, with lots of fun, lots of great time with friends and family, and some fantastic memories of things that we can just never possibly forget.